Hello, Neanderthals. Remember a couple weeks ago when I told you that Bobo Biden was contemplating regulating ghost guns and home build kits? Yep, you're gonna wanna watch this episode of Guns and Gadgets, because the hits keep coming. Hey everybody, welcome back to Guns and Gadgets, your premier source for Second Amendment news, repping my boy, Honest Outlaw, the big red beard dude. Before I jump into what drives me crazy, let's talk about our sponsor first. Thank you to Safe Life Defense for being a sponsor of Guns and Gadgets. If you're in the market for body armor, whether it's for training at the range to keep you safe or out in the real world to keep you safe, you'll probably find something that piques your fancy at Safe Life Defense. Utilize the link down below to my code right here on the screen, Guns and Gadgets 10, to save some money, but they kind of have everything you might want to thumb through. They have overt armor, they have concealable body armor, they have soft plates, they have hard plates, all kinds of different carriers and colors and nameplates you can put on them. They even have tactical belts if you're looking for something to set up your rig with. Check them out. Thank you to Safe Life Defense for sponsoring today's video. All right, guys, two bills I want to just put on your radar. They're new, so the text isn't available yet from the Library of Congress. Waiting for that, but just the titles alone and the amount of co-sponsors they have is telling. It's very telling. So the first bill is HR1477. Has 28 co-sponsors already, and that is the one that is going to, quote, modernize the Undetectable Firearms Act of 1988. That is the bill that will be coming after ghost guns and home builds and probably 80% lowers and maybe even 3D printed guns. Can't really be for sure about the 3D printing. That's usually its own bill, but I will stay, I'll keep my eyes open and my ears open for this one, but know that it's there. It is there. The attempt to ban the home builds is already in Congress, and we'll see. Also, I wanted to let you know about this bill. It was submitted by Madeline Dean, Democrat, obviously, out of Pennsylvania. And like I said, already has 28 co-sponsors, all of them Democrat. So let's keep our eyes open, share this if you would, so that other people remain in the know about what's going down, because it's going down like crazy. The second one is even more interesting, or more infringing, I would think, is HR1454. Already has 83 co-sponsors, all Democrat, but that tells you that they want this to pass. I mean, the ink isn't even done on the signature on the bill. Boom, 83 people jump behind it. 83 tyrants jumped behind it. 83 co-conspirators jumped behind this bill. Let's say it like it is. And this one was submitted by Adriano Espelot, Democrat, obviously, out of New York. And funny enough, Congressman Espelot's claim to fame is coming to America as an illegal immigrant. I'm sorry. He says undocumented immigrant. But he was an illegal alien for a year before his family got green cards when they came over from the Dominican Republic. So he came to this country to better himself. His family came to this country to better themselves, which is great. Do it the right way first. But it's fantastic. But don't bring your problems from whatever you fled to our country. And gun control is one of them. He's obviously an anti-gunner. I mean, you come to America because of the freedom and the things that keep people free. If you don't like it, there's the door, homie. But 1445, 83 co-sponsors. And this one looks to, quote, require firearm assembly kits to be considered a firearm. Yep. So build kits be considered a firearm. Does that mean parts kits would be considered a firearm? Does that mean we're going to have to go through background checks if we want to replace a trigger in our rifle? Does it mean we have to go through a background check if you want to put Gucci Glock parts on? You can see that this is very vague. Obviously, we're going to need to read this bill. But be warned, ladies and gentlemen, they just keep coming and coming and coming. They're just going to keep lambasting everything, throwing it at the wall and see what sticks, because they have that administration that ran on extreme gun control. So they're going to try to get everything they can through the House and over to the Senate. And that is where these bills, all of them, are going to hopefully die, but there's a very strong chance that they won't. but let's see what happens. I just wanted to put these two bills on your radar. Again, 1477 and 1454. The first one's coming after home builds and ghost guns, and the second one's coming after parts, firearms parts kits, to be treated as a firearm, NICS check, all that crazy stuff. And if you live in a state that has a background, has a waiting period, then you're gonna buy your trigger, go through the NICS, and then your state's mandated waiting period. That's ridiculous for something that's not a firearm. All right, guys and gals, please do me a favor, share this with everybody you know. Get this on everybody's radar. I know we're sick and tired of hearing of the constant infringements. Believe me, I'm sick and tired of hearing it too, but if we don't stay in the know, that's how they're gonna get us. I mean, look throughout history, that's how they do it. Until we see each other again, be safe, stay vigilant, carry a weapon. Please consider subscribing to Guns and Gadgets. This is where you will find all of the news on the Second Amendment. Every now and then, there's some good stuff. But if you wanna stay in the know, this is the place to do it. And I'll see you in the next one. It'll be really soon, I'm sure. Take care, everybody.